Hey there, I am so excited for this video, and not only because we're gonna look at what I think is the best and most fun archery game on the Quest 2, but I'm also going to offer you the chance to win a free game code which you can use to download the game directly from the Oculus Store. So let's go! In this video, we're gonna look at In Death Unchained, a really cool game that I've been playing pretty much non-stop since I installed it, and which is also enhanced to take advantage of the more powerful hardware on the Quest 2. And I'm gonna be doing my first ever giveaway. I'm Andy, welcome back to VR Man Cave. Ever wondered what the afterlife would be like? Well, in this game, you'll encounter a grim answer to that question, because heaven is abandoned and the balance between good and evil is completely out of whack. Lost souls, angelic creatures, and all kinds of demons and undead roam around freely between heaven and hell. This is a roguelite game, which means the basic premise of it is that you will roam through the afterlife to kill enemies and there is no way to save the game. So once you die, you have to start all over again. And you may be wondering if that doesn't get boring, but as you'll see in this review, that's very unlikely because of how the levels are designed. And I'll get into that a bit later. The basic way to move in this game is by using a teleport mechanic, but a really neatly implemented one in my opinion. If you hold down either the A or the B button while pulling on the bow, you'll see a glowing golden arrow, and when releasing it, you'll be teleported where your arrow lands. Pretty simple, but honestly, when it comes to VR, simplicity is underrated, and being able to play the whole game without fiddling around and trying to find the right button is part of why I love this game so much. The developers have recently also introduced smooth locomotion, so basically moving with your thumbstick. Personally, I use both, as I feel the smooth locomotion is a bit slow and there doesn't seem to be a way to sprint when pushing down on the thumbstick like in other games. So I use the smooth locomotion to move around smaller spaces while still using the teleport arrow for covering larger distances and getting away from a fight where I'm in over my head. Another thing I like is how they've implemented the health bar, which you'll be able to see on your bow at all times. And although you'll literally hear your heart pound when you're low on health, it's good to also have a visual representation handy at all times. At the moment, you have two options when it comes to weapons in this game. It's either a classic bow and arrow or a crossbow. I personally prefer the classic one since I feel like it offers me more control because I can decide how much I need to pull back on the bow depending on the distance between me and my enemies or how far I want to teleport with the mechanic I just mentioned earlier. And I also feel you can rain arrows on your foes quicker than with the crossbow, although that might just be me not being used to it as much as the classic bow. Do note that when you'll first enter the game, you won't have the crossbow yet as that's unlocked after you play a bit of the game. So just keep grinding and you'll see it here in the sanctuary in no time. Both weapons will be able to initially hold three types of arrows at the same time, and you'll get additional slots as you unlock more achievements in the game. There are multiple types of arrows you'll be able to use, ranging from fire arrows, ricochet ones, explosive ones, and even freezing arrows. Every time after you die, when you first enter Purgatory, you'll only have the basic arrows, for which you have infinite ammo, and you'll always also have a shield with you. You'll only be able to hold a limited number of magical arrows, and when you run out, the bow will default back to the standard ones. There are two ways to get these special arrows, and the first one is by killing enemies, which will sometimes drop either health potions or such arrows. When an enemy does drop them, all you need to do is extend your empty hand towards them and force pull them by pressing the trigger, and you'll pull that item in your hand and be able to place it in one of the empty slots on your bow. Then, to choose which one you want as your default, just hold down either X or Y on the left touch controller and simply pull the arrow type you want with your right touch controller. Of course, this is available for me since I hold my bow in my left hand. If you prefer to hold it in your right hand, then it's the other way around. The action of choosing the arrow type also slows down time, which comes in really handy when you're surrounded by a lot of enemies and need a bit of time to think what your next move should be. The second way to get magic arrows is to visit the Reliquary, which is a portal midway through the Purgatory world that takes you to what is pretty much a shop. You can turn your empty hand palm up to see your score and how much gold you've gathered from killing enemies, and if you have enough, you can buy stacks of special arrows or health potions. What you do need to be aware about is that once you die, whatever gold you had is gone. Now, let's move on to the next topic, because the developers have done something really creative and smart with this one. The developer has implemented a procedurally generated model to the game world, which basically means that every time you restart the level, all of the corridors, the towers, hallways, rooftops, and enemies are going to be arranged in a completely different layout, which keeps me constantly want to jump back in and give it another go. The game starts off with a really well put together tutorial, and then you'll find yourself in the Sanctuary, a safe place where you can view the global leaderboard, your achievements, and access the Purgatory, which is the main world you'll start off with. Once inside, the door will close behind you, leaving you with no choice than to venture off towards the looming towers, bridges, and corridors where you'll encounter increasingly difficult enemies that become more and more difficult every time you die and start again from scratch. If you manage to make it through all of these enemies in the Purgatory and beat the final boss, you'll enter the more difficult Paradise Lost. And if you beat that one too, you'll enter the Abyss, which, as you can imagine, is a pretty nasty place filled with a lot of very difficult enemies. Sometimes you'll also encounter a portal within the level that generally has a ton of enemies around it, which you'll probably want to take care of before shooting your teleport arrow through it and going to the Pit of Reformation. A very difficult mini level with special challenges and achievements that can only be completed if you beat it. If that's not enough for you, well, you'll be happy to know that the developers are releasing a free DLC called Siege of Heaven on December 8th. And thank God there are still developers that don't charge for every single extra minute of gameplay they add in. So great job, guys. And since I was just talking about enemies, you'll encounter lots of different types of enemies, from zombies, undead Templars, monks, ghosts, and many others. And since the worlds are procedurally generated, so are the enemies. So they will not only be found in different places around the map every time, but also adapt to your level of skill. So as you progress, you'll encounter more powerful and smarter enemies, and in higher numbers. The AI is pretty well made overall for a VR game, and enemies feel reasonably realistic for the world the game is set in. I did notice that if you teleport at the exact moment an enemy starts attacking you, they will still attack the position you were in initially. But that's a minor hiccup in my opinion. Your foes will sense your presence through sight, sound, and also misfired arrows. And they have a tendency to let all their buddies in that area know exactly where you are, so make sure you hit your marks, because otherwise you might have to deal with way more than you've bargained for. In which case, running away is advised, but of course you may be way more skilled than myself and be able to fight 20-30 enemies at once like freaking Legolas in Lord of the Rings. In which case, hats off to you, sir. As always, I'm gonna be super honest with you guys, I wasn't expecting to love this game as much as I do, but it manages to keep me on my toes with its randomized levels and increasingly challenging enemies. The physics of the bow, the arrows, and the enemies is really well polished, and nailing a headshot from a distant rooftop is as satisfying as it gets. I would have liked to see a bit more attention to details when it comes to the audio side of things, as it can get pretty repetitive to hear the same sounds made by enemies again and again. But to be honest, at this point I'm just nitpicking, because I'm generally way too involved in the game's action to even think about this while I'm playing. The controls are very intuitive, and by the time I finished the in-game tutorial, I was confident that I knew what I was doing. And of course it helps that the tracking is also spot on, with no noticeable drifting or loss of tracking or anything like that. Overall, the game gets a thumbs up from me, especially since the developers, Super Bright, seem to be really dedicated and constantly push out bug fixes and updates and even a new DLC soon. If you enjoy challenging archery games in VR and like the atmosphere and the mechanics of this game, I would definitely give it a try. And since I really want to give back to you guys as much as possible for all of your support and the heartwarming comments that I've received so far, let's get straight into the giveaway. I wanted to keep it really simple, so I'm not going to ask you to go on any website, sign up to anything, or do anything complicated. All you have to do for a chance to win is be subscribed to the channel, drop a like on this video, and comment below with whatever you want, but make sure to include the hashtag VRManCave. Please make sure to use the hashtag, because I'm going to be using commentpicker.com and I'm going to be filtering the comments based on that hashtag and picking a random winner from the comments that include the hashtag VRManCave. I will be recording the moment when I draw the winner, and it will be included in the next video for full transparency. I will keep the giveaway open from the moment this video is posted until the 5th of December, so make sure to throw your hat in the ring. I wish you all the best of luck, and if you don't win, don't worry, I'm going to be doing other giveaways in the future again. After you've entered the giveaway, you can either click here or here to choose what to watch next. As always, stay safe and enjoy VR, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.